Integrate this integral, we shall put x is equal to tan theta, dx will be sec square theta d theta, and therefore the integral I will be tan inverse tan theta 1 plus tan square theta whole square into value of dx sec square theta d theta is equal to tan inverse tan theta is theta, 1 plus tan square theta will be sec square theta whole square into sec square theta. So 1 sec square theta will be cancelled from numerator and denominator. Therefore, this integral becomes theta into 1 by sec square theta, we can write as cos square theta. Now theta 1 cos square theta should be written as now 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. 1 by 2 can be taken common. This integral will be divided into two integrals. The first part is theta d theta, and integral of second will be theta cos 2 theta d theta. Bracket close. Integral of theta is theta square by 2 with respect to theta. Plus, to integrate this, we shall use product rule, integration by parts, theta cos 2 theta, the first function constant, integral of second function, differential of first function, integral of second, into d theta. One by two bracket theta square by two plus theta, integral of cos two theta is sine two theta upon coefficient of theta, which is two, minus differential of theta is one, integral of cos two theta is sine two theta upon coefficient of theta two into d theta. Bracket close. Two can be taken common from denominator. So this we can write theta square plus theta sine 2 theta minus integral of sine 2 theta is minus cos 2 theta upon coefficient of theta, which is 2, plus an integral constant c. Now the important thing is to eliminate theta. We have substituted x is equal to tan theta. So instead of theta, you cannot write directly tan inverse x. Wherever theta is there, you write tan inverse x. No, the value should be very simplified. So let us see how this can be simplified. 1 by 4 is there. Theta square definitely is not a problem because theta is tan inverse x theta. Sine 2 theta we can write as 2 sine theta cos theta. Minus into minus will be plus. 1 by 2 is there. Cos 2 theta you can write 1 minus tan square x upon 1 plus tan square x, if you know this thing. 1 minus tan square theta upon 1 plus tan square theta, if you know. Otherwise, if you don't know this formula, no problem. Suppose if you know any of the formula like this, cos square theta minus sin square theta. Please keep yourself mute. Cos square theta minus sin square theta. The most important formula or the most known formula is this: cos 2 theta is cos square theta minus sin square theta. Even if you know this formula, you can find integral of the given question. So what we have substituted now, let us see. Tan theta is equal to x. Tan theta is equal to x, and if there is nothing in denominator, we can write 1. It becomes perpendicular upon base. Now let's make a right triangle over here. Perpendicular is x, base is 1. Therefore, hypotenuse will be root 1 plus x square. So with the help of this triangle, we shall find all the values of sin theta cos theta means trigonometric ratios. 1 by 4 value, as far as theta is concerned, theta is not a problem. Theta you can find directly. What is theta? Theta is tan inverse x. So instead of theta, you will write tan inverse x. That's it. So tan inverse x whole square, okay, plus theta is tan inverse x. 2 is there, so you can write 2 tan inverse x. And for the value of sine theta, you will have to use, means we shall have to use this right triangle. And value of sine theta is perpendicular upon hypotenuse, therefore it becomes x upon root over 1 plus x square into value of cos theta is base upon hypotenuse, 1 upon root 1 plus x square. And if you know sine 2 theta is 2 tan theta upon 1 plus 10 square theta, then it can save your time. And if you don't know, no problem at all. You can integrate with the help of this method. 1 by 2 cos square theta is base upon hypotenuse, so 1 upon root over 1 plus x square whole square minus sine square theta. Sine theta is perpendicular upon hypotenuse, so it is x upon root over 1 plus x square whole square plus an integral constant c. Now we shall simplify it and the job will be done. 1 by 4. Here in first step, nothing to simplify. It will remain tan inverse x whole square. You cannot write tan to the power minus 2. Okay. You cannot write this as this. So keep this thing in mind. And this numerator is twice x tan inverse x. And denominator you can see root 1 plus x square into root 1 plus x square will be 1 plus x square plus 1 by 2. Here denominator in both the steps are same. So being denominator same, they can be taken common, 1 plus x square, because both are in squares, and numerator becomes 1 minus x square plus an integral constant c. So finally, this is the integral of given integral, tan inverse x upon 1 plus x square whole square. An important integral it is.